Chase, you know what this is?
It looks like a blower.
No, this is a heart attack waiting to happen. Now, there's nothing worse when you get out there and you're going to cut your grass and your blower mower don't start, or perhaps your lawnmower doesn't start. You might weed eat, you may go out there and edge your grass, and then all of a sudden you want to mow and nothing happens. That's aggravating.
Well, that's why we need to go through this complete lawnmower and make sure that don't happen.
Yeah, and that's what this segment's all about. We're going to show you how to go through your lawnmower. We're going to check the electrical system, things like the battery, the starter motor, show you some voltage drops. We're even going to replace the starter. So when you get out there to cut your grass, it's not going to happen to you.
Let's go ahead and pick this seat up right here and start at the battery.
That's a perfect place to start. You always want to start at the battery. And if you take a look at the system with us here, you can see right here, we got our battery. Now our battery leads to a solenoid. Then when you turn the key, the solenoid actually is going to energize that power and send it over here to the starter motor.
Let's take a look at the battery. You know, connections are a big part of the starting system. So we'll start right here at the battery. We've got connections here. You know, you may want to look at those connections and put some dielectric grease on there, maybe some anti-seize to make sure they make good contact, because that's a very, very vital to the starting system.
That's for sure. And we want to check the battery. So I'm going to set up this meter here on volts. And we'll show you at home actually what's going on. You want to make sure your battery's fully charged. That's always the first place to start. And we'll just come across the positive and the negative terminal of the battery. And you can see this battery showing above 12 volts. So this battery's in good shape. This one here has enough cranking power to get the job done. All right, then we can go one step further. We can go down to the solenoid. We can look at it and we can check for voltage drops. Now, voltage drops is a good way to check for any resistance. Maybe you have a loose cable, bad cables, frayed cables, whatever it may be. In order to do that, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna leave the meter in volts and I'm gonna go here from the positive cable all the way over to the starter motor.
I'll go ahead and disable this ignition so we can crank it over.
Make sure you disable ignition, and then you want to crank it over because you want the amps and the voltage to run through it. Go ahead. Good. This one's showing about 0.07, not even a tenth of a volt. So this system's in good shape. Now, if you had a voltage drop there, we could take it step by step and isolate it. We can simply come over from the battery to the solenoid. We can do it again. There's our 0.1. We can go across the solenoid and do it again. A little bit there. I have a good cutaway of a solenoid right here. We're looking at these two contacts right here. That battery wire's coming into this one, and then it's transferring the power out to the starter motor. What happens is when this plunger goes in, I can push it in there, and you can see that's making the electrical contact from the bat wire to the motor wire. Now we got some windings in here. When you turn the key, it magnetically induces a voltage and magnetically pushes that plunger in and causes that contact to happen.
You know, John, lawnmowers sit out there in the elements all the time, and these windings right here can get some electric light in there, maybe corrode up, and it's definitely going to affect the starting system.
That is. That's going to hurt the starter because we've got a voltage drop here, so it's going to start for the voltage it needs. Now, we can go one step further. We can take one more voltage drop, and we can go from the actual starter motor solenoid here, right from the solenoid, over to the motor, and that's going to check that final cable. So if you go ahead and hit it one more time. Great. You can see 0.03. You don't want anything less than 0.5, which is a half a volt. If you had a voltage drop, you want to check for some resistance. And I have some cables here we can show you, all right? This one here, we actually frayed it all off. And this is why I don't like to use ohms of resistance. Voltage drop's a little bit better. Now look at that, we got 0.1. Now here's a brand new cable, that's perfect. And that's showing 0.1. So it's showing the identical ohms of resistance, but you can see you're not gonna get any amperage through this wire. So voltage drop is the way to go for checking any resistance. What about these wires?
Looks like if you had these on your mower, they're not gonna bend around. They're probably gonna end up breaking. Not a very good wire for the lawnmower here.
So type of wire matters, and also where you route it. Be careful, because this right here is gonna cause some heat. Heat causes resistance. That starter motor is not gonna get the voltage and amperage it needs to perform right.
You know, wires here like run along the lawnmower here, they may look good on the outside and take this little cover off. It may look fine on the outside, but on the inside, you can get corrosion, electrolyte running up, wicking up the wire here, gonna cause resistance and the starter's not gonna operate properly.
Yeah, and this one's operating fine, but we're gonna go ahead and remove and replace the starter. So in case you have a problem at home with your starter, you'll know how to fix it. Now that you saw how to test the mower, if you had a starter issue, we're going to show you how to replace one. So why don't you come around with us and we'll show you down here where the starter is.
The starter is actually located right here. And what I have John do is go ahead and disconnect the battery before we remove the starter so we don't get any spark.
All right, that's a great idea. Now I'll come over here to the negative battery cable. I like to remove the negative battery cable because there's no spark on that side.
John, I'll go ahead and remove this cover here.
Perfect. Now I don't want this ever to touch or be connected while we're doing a starter motor because remember that hot wire goes directly to it. You can short out the system. So once that's away and far enough away, we'll go ahead and start removing the shroud. I'll give you a hand.
All right, there's a couple bolts on the back.
Now what we're doing is we're going to pull this whole shroud off. Now you might not have to do that. There's two bolts you may get to with some swivel heads down here, but we're going to pull it off so we can show you exactly what's going on with that starter motor. And you'll get a better look at it. Perfect. Now you can get a really good shot of what's going on. You can see the actual pinion of the starter right here. You can see the flywheel. Chase, why don't you tell them how to go ahead and remove that starter?
All right, now that we've got the battery disconnected, I'm gonna go ahead and unhook our power wire down here so we don't get any spark and it'll be out of the way. And then I got a 12 millimeter bolt inside here and one 12 millimeter bolt inside here. And I'll pull them out and the starter come right on out.
This is a really good look here. You can see the magnetos right here. Let's say perhaps you are cranking your mower and it cranks over real good, but it doesn't start. Well, that would be a spark issue or a fuel issue. If you had fuel and no spark, this is what controls the spark right here. This actually gets a magnetic signal, takes it in there, makes a big spark happen, and it comes down the spark plug wire, and it goes right down here to your cylinder. Once you got a spark tester in there, turn it over and see if you have spark. If you had spark, you know it's a fuel issue. How are we doing there?
Just about got it.
Look at that. Perfect.
There's our starter motor.
Man, you made that look easy. All right, there's two bolts right there he just showed you that went into the block. And here's our lug. So what we want to do is we want to take our other starter, make sure we got that lug right there. We got our little bolt holes right there. This is a nice brand new starter. Just take your bolt off here for you.
I'm going to put a little dielectric grease on there so we don't have to worry about any corrosion.
Anytime you're dealing with lawnmowers, boats, ATVs, it's probably a good idea to use the dielectric grease there for your connections. And then anti-seize on your bolts because it's in harsh climates, harsh conditions.
Thank you. I'll go ahead and bolt this thing back up here. I got two 12 millimeter bolts and just bolts right in.
And just take your time. Make sure you hand start all your bolts. You don't want anything cross-threaded. That's a lot of extra work for no reason. Don't put a ratchet on them till you feel comfortable that they're threading in there real nice. Yeah, those are going perfect. All right, you stop right there. Go ahead and hook your battery cable up.
I'll get this tightened up. John, if you'll go ahead and hook up the battery, we'll give it a shot.
Great. Now, we always do the negative, so I'm going to put the negative back. That avoids any sparking. It's just a safer way to do it. All right, so if I tighten this up, and you want it good and snug. We tested for voltage drops earlier. We don't want any voltage drop in the system. We want that starter to get the full voltage and the full amperage. Now, if you look over here, what we have is a pinion. It's always a good idea while you got it apart. We can go ahead and test it. Make sure that that pinion contacts that flywheel good. Let's spin it over. That one looks good. Now, pinion contact's real important. You saw that pinion come up and contact that flywheel? Here's a tip for you, whether you're working on a car or whatever you're working on. A lot of times, if there's a high-pitched whine when you're cranking, you know, usually what's happening is that pinion's too far away from the flywheel. And then on the other hand, if you're cranking it, da-da-da-da-da-da, and you release the key and you get that wheel, that's because it's too close and that pinion's hanging up with that flywheel. And then when it releases, you hear that high-pitched whine.
I'm sure glad this one's in good shape. Once we get this back together, my grandma's gonna be happy, so I can get over there and cut her grass and she'll quit getting on to me.
Yeah, when she calls, you gotta run. Now, you got to see the whole starter. We're just gonna button this back up, put the top pieces back on. While you do that, I'll tell them a little bit about maintenance. Now, maintaining one of these lawnmowers is important. Any UTV, ATV, tractor, or boat for that matter. And why is that? Because they're in harsh conditions. Now, you always want to change the oil filter. I have a cutaway of an oil filter right here. You can see the pleated material. What happens is the oil goes through it, comes through these pleated material, and returns back to the engine. So you have clean oil. Now, the fuel filter, same thing. There's pleated material inside of the fuel filter here. The fuel's going to come in. It's going to have to go through this filter area before it gets to the engine so you don't do any damage. Now, really important on all these, and this one's right here, is the air filter. You can see the air filter right here. Now think about it. You're mowing the grass, dirt's flying up, everything's flying through there. It's going to end up getting it to the engine, and sand is sand. It's sandpaper. Once it gets into the cylinder, it starts to do damage. So it's a good idea to change this.
You know, John, I got a little tip for them too. You know, they say you should never beat your old air filter out because you're going to break up the debris inside of here, and it can suck right down the carburetor and cause some problems.
Yeah, that's a good tip. Now also, just hose off your deck. Make sure there's nothing in there when you're mowing. Make sure everything's clean. Matter of fact, I remember coming over and you were replacing a sliding glass door.
Yeah, because I was mowing the yard and actually kicked a rock and just busted the door right out.
That's another good tip. Mow away from the glass.
Definitely.
Now, if you want to watch more videos, you know, we have UTVs, ATVs, choppers, Gixxers. We have everything in here but a Humvee. And you know, it's only a click away. We're going to go ahead and put a starter on an ATV.
A boat.
And we're going to do a starter and an alternator on a tractor. Thanks for watching.